All right, everybody. Well, here it is. I'm going to try to do the binding repair or screw it completely up. So what the plan is here to start off with is I'm going to have to go in here with a heat gun and a razor blade and heat this up without actually melting it and peel the binding away from the wood. And then I'll take a chisel, and I got to make a straight cut. It's at a 45 degree angle on each side of the break, and then cut off me another piece of binding and do the opposite cut on there and just put it on there, right? Sounds easy enough. Well, I don't know how easy it's going to be, but I'm going to give it hell. So I'll be back. So here's something kind of cool. I got some new tools. So new tools are always awesome. So this is a brand called Works. It's this 20 volt system. And what's really cool is I needed a heat gun. I needed to get a rotary tool. There's some other stuff I need to get. But what's really cool is they're all powered by this one battery. There's this cool little controller. It just ends up sliding right onto the battery. Let me just go ahead and do that for you. There, it's locked on just like that. And then it comes off with this really heavy duty kind of a braided cable. It's not even, not kind of a braided cable. It is a braided cable. Then it's got this cool little like 3-pin connector. And that goes in the bottom right here to the tool. This is the heat gun. This thing weighs like a few ounces. It's very, very lightweight. I don't know how well it's going to work, but we're gonna check that out right now. So I'll be back. As you can hear, it's rolling, and yeah, it's pretty toasty. So I think that's going to be all right. I'll be back after I get the binding pulled off. Oh, see, here's the controller. Kind of with the rotary tool, that's going to be the speed controller as well. And then when you want to turn it off, there's a power switch. It's pretty cool stuff. I think it's going to help me out a lot. So I'll get to pulling this stuff off, and I'll be back. All right. Well, the heat gun worked really, really well. So I was able to go in here. I heated this up. I got underneath here with a razor blade, and I peeled this up to give me a little working room here. And so what I'll do here is, if this thing will focus, is I'll go across here with a chisel, and I'm going to back it with something, and I just got to make a flat edge here, and then I will... I'll probably end up pulling this back down here with the heat and then measuring out my distance here. Cut me off a little piece of binding to stick in there. A little bit of super glue right here and a little more heat. And then I got a secret little tool to, well, it's not a tool. It's a filler, basically. I'm gonna get some acetone and shave off some binding off of my new stuff and create this kind of a gooey filler, and it'll match the splits that'll be left by the little piece of binding that'll be put in there. So it should all come out pretty well, hopefully. So we'll see how that goes. I don't know why my camera isn't focusing for crap. Anyway, all right, I'll be back. Take a picture. looking thing. Alright, so I got my chisel out and ready to go. These are some super cool chisels. But I'm just going to go up here and I'm going to just take this thing off right here at the end. That way I've got a nice straight edge right here. This is already nice and straight, but there's still that wood damage in here. So what I was thinking of doing once I get the binding repaired, I could put the filler in behind there and then squirt in a little bit of glue, I think, but we'll see how it goes. Right on. Well, I've got the wood filler on there. It's kind of a two-part epoxy putty type stuff. So you cut off a little bit and then you knead it together. It looks like this stuff. It is actually this stuff. It's JB Weld Quickwood. So it comes out kind of like that color right there after you knead it all together. Of course, I only needed like less than, a very, very small amount. But I figured that's better to have more than not enough. So there it is. It's just sitting there. It says you got about 60 minutes to wait, and then it's time to do whatever you need to do to it. So I'm going to go do something for an hour. If it's good or bad, I don't know. So I'll be back. Right on. Well, I measured out with a micrometer the missing piece of binding. I cut that off with a chisel, and that's what we got. 9.7 millimeters of binding. And when I go over here and look at this, you can see the uneven line right there? That's the damage to the wood that it's I don't know if it's going to focus in. But anyway, needless to say, but I'm going to say it, it's filled in. So that's actually pretty cool. So I'm going to let this thing probably dry overnight, even though they say it's good to go in an hour. And I think that's it for today. I'm going to button up everything here, and that's it. I'll be back tomorrow.